creating lab, sorry, creating creating reports, right, with Commvault. All right, so typically this is the answer question. One of the subscribers in my channel. Anyway, so, okay, so how do you create a report, right, basically? So you go to job summary, CommServe. Then you select, say, you have two different ones. So let's do the one, right? So you have the calendar one. The calendar tells you it'll look like the client, and then it'll say like the date. And if you choose however many dates you can choose, say like 24 hours, how many dates, 24 days, 7 days, whatever. The other one is your detailed. So the detailed is going to put like the client, and then the details. When did it back up? The difference being in client or sort of calendar, you can just look at it. You can scan it and say, okay, here you go. Let's take a look to see if it won't have anything, but let's run it anyway. It won't have any data, right? Obviously, but I'll just show you what it looks like. And run, you know, and you could schedule it. I don't have any early mute point, but. Anyway, yeah, so basically the calendar is the client, left-hand side, let's say it's this, and then to the right, it'll have the dates, top of the dates. Now, you signify the dates by being, you know, the dates here, 7 days, 20 days, 10 days, whatever. And I'll do a couple jobs, I guess, in a later video, and I'll show you what it looks like in more detail. But typically in the environment, like when you're a Commvault admin, typically this is the thing first thing you look at. Come in, maybe you get a report or whatever. It really depends on how many clients you have. If you have thousands of clients, definitely this is what you want to do. You don't want to do detailed. So you click on calendar, and then however many, you know, what are your clients? What are your media agents? What are your store policies? The time, date. So, you know, you put like maybe say typically you have thousands of clients. You can do say like 4 days or something, right? You do that, or 7 days, whatever, if you want to look at a trend. And then you can either, you know, you what you do is you schedule it. Click on schedule. And it's going to, you know, you're going to name it whatever, weekly, daily, whatever. It's going to retain that same information. See right here? It's going to retain that. And you put the notifications on, you know, who you want to send it to. You can also put an email address here as well. You can do attachments. Don't recommend. Just put embedded. And that way it's a nice, clean spreadsheet. Or, sorry, clean HTML, like a website. You just look at it, scan it, and good to go. You can also do an output. So you can output it to an HTML format, or you can do a text, so you can do an Excel file, so you can, you know, export it to Excel file when it comes to you. A couple different variations, but typically an administrator, Commvault admin, is going to have this report. You know, if they look at it every day, especially if they have, like, say, thousands of them, right? Now, there's some other tools that you can use, like third-party tools, that do the job alerts every day. But those are different tools than Commvault. This is built in, of course. Like I said, if you have, 100, 1,000, whatever you have, this is something to use when you set up your CommServe. Anything you can do to make your job easier, so you can focus on other tasks at hand. So, thanks a lot. We'll see you in the next one.